And here we go. Hello there, thanks for joining me. I am AVStoryteller, and this is my Sid Meier's Pirates. I should have said, oh, hurry there, mateys. That would be more appropriate, wouldn't it? Right, this is a brand new Let's Play. I love the Sid Meier's Pirates, and I thought I actually was going to webcam this one up, actually. So you got about 5 seconds warning before I open that webcam. Okay, just in case you don't want to see what I look like. The sound's going to cut off for just a second while I do this. There I am. Hello there, thanks for joining me. Now, I love Sid Meier's Pirates, and it's a game I keep coming back to again and again and again because it's such so much fun, and there's so many different ways you can do it. Now, unfortunately, can't find my Dread Pirate Robert's outfit anywhere. You think I'm joking? I'm not. But I've got my adventuring hat because I'm an adventurer and you have to do these things properly. So, let's play Pirates. Let's fire in there and I'll explain what the game is about as we go along.
It began with a celebration. Indebted for years to the Marquis Montalban, a family's prosperity was soon to be restored.
I like how there's no actual narration over the top of it. Kind of kept it to the original intro. There's our young hero there.
Befouled by an unwelcome guest. The fleet had been lost, and the debt had come due. Family's property was seized, and they were pressed into bondage.
We're not going to stand for that, are we?
No, of course not. Boo.
Skull and crossbows over the eye patch, classy.
And so it was that the brave young scion escaped his family's fate, swearing to save them, and one day avenge the Marquis's foul deeds.
10 years later,
it looks really nice. It's a really nice looking game, and it's very low demanding. So if you don't have like a bleeding edge system, it's like you can still play it on full whack. It's excellent.
Seeking passage to the new world, you inquire at a public house. If ye be looking for passage to the Americas, ye can sign up here. Ha 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 ha.
Okay, Jacques Ramirez, usually my go-to pirate's name, but this time I'm gonna mix it up a bit and go for Robert, as in Dread Pirates thereof. Right, experience is the difficulty level of the game, starting off as apprentice, journeyman, and it basically affects how tough, and I love how the character changes as you look at that. Gonna swash some buckle, I can tell you, rogue. But we're gonna adventure this up, so I'm an adventurer. Skill now, pro tip: there's several ways to play this game, but if you want to focus on the main quest of rescuing your family and avenging them, then go for fencing, and you need to focus solely on that mission. Try not to get distracted by being too much of a pirate or helping out governors or wooing governor's daughter. I'll get to that, yeah, babes. Because as your character levels, he grows older. When you share out the plunder, your character goes forward a few years and you get slower and slower as the game goes along. So it's best, because the count and the marquis, sorry, is so tough in a fencing fight, you want to like get that over and done with as soon as possible while you're still, your character is still young, and having that fencing skill is a huge advantage to doing that. If you were playing the long game, not interested so much in completing the main quest, as though you can maybe rescue a few of your family members, and you just want to survive as a pirate as long as possible, go for the medicine skill, because as you age, it has a less of a detrimental effect on your skills and abilities. Wit and charm, love the roses. Oh, and as your difficulty goes up, look at that. From the single rose to boom. There you go. One of the new additions to the game is a ballroom dance scene, it's a mini game which you use to impress the governor's daughters. And as a result of that, they give you like special items, and eventually you can like go through and marry them after a few other little quests. But we'll get to that later. Navigation improves your seamanship and helps in sailing against the wind. Just love the little touches like that. Gunnery improves your ship-to-ship battles. And fencing. So I'm going to go ahead with fencing. It's just a solid choice. If you're not sure, fencing is always a good solid choice. And these are the different eras or where your adventure can be set. I'm going to keep it as the Buccaneer's Heroes, basically the golden age of being a Buccaneer. And if it's your first time playing Sid Meier's Pirates, I would recommend doing that. Just basically keep all the defaults and just play it all through. It's a great game. You can just keep coming back to this again and again and again. Now, we need to sign up as part of a crew. The captain at yonder table will gladly take ye aboard. So, we have got the English, the Dutch, the Spanish, and the French. Now, in the Caribbean, the Spanish own the most amount of towns and cities. So, if you want an easier adventure, start off being friendly with the Spanish, because that means you got more towns and more friendly ports to go into. But likewise, if you want to do a lot of pirating or a lot of privateers, because there's a lot of Spanish towns and a lot of Spanish ships, it means it's a target rich environment. It all depends on how you want to play this. Dutch is by far the hardest, I would say, because they have such few towns and cities in the Caribbean, so you've got very few friendly ports. This can change over time. I mean, these four are constantly warring with each other, and it tells you who's currently at war with each. The English is probably the standard middle of the road choice. I think I'm going to go ahead with that one. Welcome aboard, Mr. Roberts. We sail with the tide. The crossing was fraught with terror and cruelty. The captain drove the ship and the crew to breaking point. Was that the point? It was close to it, but wasn't quite at the breaking point. There you go, that's the breaking point. Pushed beyond all decency, the crew mutinies. Avast! And it's very Disney kind of violence. You never see anyone get killed. It's already always comedy defeats. Curse blood. Feel good family fun. Free and under full sail, the ship and its crew at your command. You make your way into the Caribbean. But you can't help wonder, where has all the rum gone? A fortune to be had. A family to rescue. And revenge to be served. And there are your four family members for you to save, if you so wish. Okay, and it starts you off, and it points you in towards the town of your nationality of choosing, in this case, the English capital of Barbados. Now, there's several options of what you can do. Talk to the governor, meet the governor's daughter, get a letter of marque, visit the tavern, get crew members. So we'll go through all this in turn, and I'll try and give you as quickly as can an overview of the adventures, and then we'll get out to sea and start plundering. So governor, go to the governor first. And all the governors all look different depending on the nationality, and your character's outfit changes depending on how what rank you are in the navy. You may be interested to know that we are at war with the evil Spanish and the slimy French. I am pleased to offer a letter of marque which authorizes you to plunder and sink the ships of our enemies. Ha ha! Legalized pirates. As this map will show, the nearest enemy city is the French city of Martinique, which lies a short distance to the northwest. Yeah, because not only can you attack ships, you can attack ports. And then you can get into land battles as well. Awesome stuff. And here we are, a very helpful map of where it is. So we're there. English flag, French flag. Of course, you don't have to do this. It's just useful information. I am about to send the brig Queen Elizabeth to blockade Martinique. Perhaps you would like to tag along and pluck a few French prizes. So basically, you're going to have another friendly ship in the waters next to you, which you could take advantage of. Now, this time, we never got to see the governor's daughter, probably because it's just the first time we've seen the governor. So, let's visit the tavern, I'm thinking. Actually, let's go look at our ship. Pirate Ship Revenge, which is a sloop, and it tells you a whole host of very useful information, how much damage to the sail and to the hull, and you can actually change the sail emblems if you so wish. Chain shot are useful for taking down sails, which slows down the enemy ship, meaning that you can run rings around them. Grape shot basically kills the crew, defeats the crew, and makes them jump overboard, which means that the ship is mostly intact. So if you do want to capture the ship so you can sell it, you don't want to destroy it and put big holes in it. So this is how much gold I've got, how much space I've got in my hold, and you can have more than one ship at a time. And if there was upgrades available, it will tell you here what those upgrades were and how much they cost. So, and we can't rename this one just yet. Right, there was not much for us to do there. So let's trade with the merchant. No, let's go visit the tavern. Tavern's always good. Now this is where you can hire crews, get rumours, get even more rumours. Speak to the shady character in the corner who may have maps or special items which will make your life a lot easier. So the city of Barbados has gathered at the tavern this evening to discuss the latest happenings, including the fact that you have received an English letter of marque. Who would you like to talk to? And I like that little touch. It really makes you feel like the game is reacting to what you do. So if you get a special item like a fencing shirt or a new magnifying glass, it might mention that here. So let's go do this in order. Let's go speak to the barkeep. The shipwright in Trinidad can upgrade your ship with cotton sails. If you like, your ship will sail faster. Very useful. So you can then check your map, find out where Trinidad is, make some money, go over there. Wenenzella to you too. It's pretty quiet around here, sweetie. Okay, no information today. We don't have any money, really. Yeah, we've got 100 gold, but a mysterious traveller offers to sell you a ruby ring. Robert, this will help you win the heart of the governor's daughter, and it can be yours for only 2,600 gold pieces. Fortunately, I've only got 100. So we'll need to do something about that. Right. Come on, you scurvy dogs. Despite the booming economy, the adventurous band of 30 men offer to join your crew of 40. Yes, I'm going to welcome you aboard. If in doubt, get lots of crew. There's always pros and cons to all these things, but I don't want to weigh you down with too much information to begin with, and then we'll head out. So let's just quickly check the status. Actually, this gives you a brief update of what's happening with you. So you started your career in 1660, the Buccaneer Heroes, as the English captain. You are currently an adventurer captain with skill at fencing. You are now 18 years old and in excellent health. That's the important part. Your crew of 70 is very happy, and it can go down as far as mutinous, at which point you're in big trouble. How do you keep your crew happy? Make money, booty, plunder. And this tells you how much food you've got, and depending on how much crew you've got, how many months that will last. And any good, because you could be a merchant in this game, you could just trade goods from one city to the next. And there's a whole bunch of other things down here, we'll get to them, but let's get out to sea, I'm thinking. And let's sail away. So, You use it. You control it using the arrow keys. And the wind generally goes from east to west. So if I bring up the map ever so quickly, this is the map of the Caribbean. Where's we is at? All the yellow is Spanish towns and cities. X marks the spot where we are. And the gold symbol tells you how wealthy that particular town is. So if you were to capture that town, you would get a big bonus of gold doubloons. The cannonball represent how well fortified and defended they are, which means a very a tougher fight. And so the orange flags are the Dutch, blue are the French. Port Royal, for those of you who remember the Pirates of the Caribbean movie, and Tortuga, that's where they went to. So as you can see, the Spanish main. Now, once you capture a city, you can actually change it to a flag of your choosing, which you can, you know, can be very advantageous. So I think we're going to follow this ship of that left Barbados, and I'm going to just attack pirates rather than the other nationalities at the moment, if I come across any. Yeah, and the wind generally goes from east to west, which, so if I'm turning this way, I would tend to pick up speed quicker, especially if I go into full sail. Oh, because I bumped in too close to that English ship, it's asking me whether or not I want to start a fight. I do not. But this is a good indication of how powerful your ship is. You've got 8 guns, 70 men, 22 guns to the 180 men. We're at a severe disadvantage. So they're going to attack this city of Martinique. If I reef my sail, which basically reduces them by half, gives me a tighter turning circle, and slows me down. That allows me to take stock of the situation. Oh, let's fire in a couple of shots. Why not? Boom! Boom! Oh! Now it's opened up. Who have we got here? If you hover your mouse over a ship, it'll bring up a bit of information. Large English merchant ship. Military payroll! Yeah, we're not going to be able to take that on. That's far too powerful for us. Oh, what's this thing? What's this monster doing? The ship bearing the military payroll has arrived in Martinique, which, if we go to the map, I don't remember it having any gold coins when I first looked at the map. I could be wrong, but generally you would see that the amount of gold that is available if you capture the place goes up. That was a bit of fun. I'm not going to attack the city actually, because I've only got a few men. So I think what I need to do is just try and find myself a pirate ship. Ooh, here we go. Pirate raiders. Let's see if we can catch up. And then we get into a ship-to-ship battle. I'll zoom in here a bit. It's a sloop. It's another one like us. It looks like the English are in a fight with the French there. Pirate ship Cassandra. Come here, you. Now, you can fire off a few before you actually get into combat range, but generally you have to like get in close. So let's attack, and this is where you go to the attack screen. So they've got 8 guns. Sorry, I've got 8 guns, they've got 4 guns. Oh, and they're coming right at me. Oh, yep. Got a few hits in there. Oh no, they went straight into a fencing attack. So this is where we actually go into fencing combat. Now this is where your crew comes in useful, because the more crew you have, you'll notice at the bottom there's going to be 2 bars of how much crew I've got, how much crew they've got, and that slowly dwindles after a while. If that gets down to 0, then you've lost the battle. It also affects how fast you are attacking and how fast the enemy attacks. So that's a good thing about having a lot of crew. The negative thing is that you have to steal a lot more bounty, a lot more gold to keep them happy. And the longer you're out at sea, the longer, the harder it is to keep your crew happy. So there you go. Right, I'm gonna go with the rapier, which is the fastest of the weapon but does the least amount of damage. And here we go. Oh dear, I'm doing it horribly dong. Oh dear! Oh, my fingers were in completely the wrong place. That's why I was doing so badly there. Sorry, this huge mic in front of my face. Thus ends the illustrious career of the Dread Pirate Roberts. No, I basically just lost my ship. You are captured and put ashore on a desert island. Many months passed before you were rescued by a passing pirate ship. Your men elect you as captain. So there's a screen you probably, well, hopefully, don't get to see very often. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. So, here we go. So, if that had happened, like, once you were, like, really into the game, then obviously you would have lost a lot of stuff. So that could have happened, that happened at the best possible time. So let's have a quick look at the fleet status. So, being the first ship, it's still called the Revenge. 40 crew and 75 max. So, while we're in here, this shows you your personal status. Now, I've still got my letter of marque from the English. I can get similar letters from all the nationalities and also different ranks as well. Wealth points, pirates defeated. This fills up with the names of all the famous pirates, which are these gentlemen down here. Roberts is currently right at the bottom. Ships captured, towns ransacked, promotions earned, treasure found, and unique items. Things like the ruby ring, the shady character was trying to sell me. And then, this is the interesting stuff. Loss of relative quests, like you have to find pieces of a map in order to track down your relatives to rescue them. Let's keep the record of that. Lost cities, fabulous cities of gold, you know, Aztec gold. All very cool. Romances, governor's daughters. We'll get to that as soon as we can. Villains avenged. So let's get back into it. Now, where exactly on the map are we? Let's pop into St. Martin, actually. As good a place as any. There's that. The different type of ships have a different number of maximum guns, crew complements, and some of them, just a few of them, have a very interesting hull design, which is a what they call a shallow draft. I've got all the details here. I love this game. But basically, there's parts of the open sea that have shallow reefs. Now, most ships, if they go across them, will tear up their hull. But there's two ships, the sloop and the Pinnace, P-I-N-N-A-C-E, have these shallow drafts. This means that they can skim across the top without taking damage, and that has saved my life against the a military man of war a number of times, where it could outrun me and outgun me, but I managed to get it to follow me across these shallow reefs, tore up its hill, and suddenly it was a tortoise and I was a hare, and there was much rejoicing. Let's talk to the governor. Dear Mr. Roberts, please come in. You may be interested to know that we are at war with the evil... Everyone's at war with the Spanish and the slimy French. Oh, I was rather hoping we were going to see the governor's daughter there. Let's go to the tavern, pick up some scurvy dogs. Let's speak to the barkeeper. The economy here stinks. I bet if we got a new governor from the nearby settlement, things would really pick up. Yes, you can get missions from the governor saying that I'm going to go to this or that town or city and ask you to escort them, and if you escort them, because they will get attacked otherwise, if they arrive, then they will become the new governor, which you can use to your advantage if they are of a friendly nationality. It is rumoured that there's a skilled navigator on board the Childhood. I believe she's an English sloop bound... Ah, she would have to be English, wouldn't she? Okay, so yeah, there's certain types of different crews. Doctor, Navigator, Gunner, which can help improve, you know, all those specific aspects of your ship. But it would generally mean that you attack the ship, capture it, and take the crew member. However, I want to stay on friendly terms with the English for the time being. Right, a mysterious traveller offers to sell you a weather glass. Robert, this instrument aids sailing near storms and hurricanes and can be yours for only 1200. Unfortunately, I've only got 100. You might have noticed on the sea map, there was like clouds. That's not just decoration. If you sail your ship through these white clouds, you'll pick up speed, which is very useful sometimes if you're trying to chase down a fort or get away from a fort. And some of them are black storm clouds, which do the same, but can also cause you damage. But that may be the only thing that stops you from getting sunk. So it makes it quite interesting. Lots of depths to this game, lots of hidden depths. Right, you scurvy dog, times are tough. A hardy band of 30 men offers to join your crew. Welcome aboard, mateys. And I don't think there's much more that we can do. Yep, nothing to do there. Divide the plunder is where, after you've been at sea and you can no longer keep your crew happy, or sooner if you want to, you can decide that I'm going to share what wealth we have gained already. And depending on the difficulty of your game, like Adventurer or Swashbuckler, the bigger the share of the gold you keep, which again makes your score at the end game all the more better. So I just thought I would quickly show you this. But this time I'm going to say, never mind, we'll divide later when we've actually got something. So let's sail away and see what adventures awaits us. And let's pick a destination. Where shall we go? Let's just head down south here, I'm thinking. Because the more you go across here, because the wind blows from right to left, you get across here very quickly, but see, getting back sometime, it can be quite a long journey. And again, that's how where different ships have different advantages, their different sail setup. Some are better at sailing almost indirectly into the wind than others are. So all these ships are not just, you know, pretty different sizes. The actual mechanics of them are very different as well. So, oh, there's one of those storm clouds I was referring to. Zoom out. What have we got here? French? Oh, smugglers, you'll do. Let's fight. And turn. Reefing yourselves can be useful for turning quickly. This is my gun loading speed down here. I'll try and prolong this so you can see more about what is actually happening. Oh, this is where you can change your type of chain or grape shot. So if I want to take down his sails, I'll be wanting to use the chain shot. If I want to kill his crew, I'll be using the grape shot. And if you just want to damage the hull, then you use the round shot. Dodge that one. And again, the weather, the wind direction is still left to right here. Oh, and as you can see, it's slowly getting dark. Sometimes if you're really losing the battle, you can try to outdistance them, or at least just survive long enough so nightfall comes and you escape in the night. I think that's enough. Let's strip the grape shot. Oh, it's completely missed. Try and get some of the crew down, and then we're going to go in. Oh, and these little guys, if you pick them up, they become part of your crew. Right, gonna reef the sails. And you get a loyal crew member who would have drowned otherwise. Attack! Right, fingers in the right position this time, please. Oh, and it's a nighttime fight. So I'll try to not go directly for the kill so you can see exactly what's happening. So you got my crew down at the bottom there, and his of 40. When he misses or gets parry, he gets slightly dizzy, which slows down his reaction speed. And that red advantage bar is determined by how well you're doing in the fencing and obviously how much crew you've got compared to him. So you can win by actually just getting his crew down to 0 from 21 or by finishing the fight. You see how I lost the fight? I was over to the far right of the ship, and this time we're over to the far left. And there you go. So he's not dead, he just got knocked off to the ship. Hey, and this is ours. Let's share the booty. This is where you get the option of keeping or sinking the ship. Tells you if they've got improved sails, which they have here. They've got chain shot, and that's fine powder, which means that your cannon fire fires further. Very useful. So I'm going to take all their stuff. If we sink her and we don't have enough hull space in our ship that we've got, it will let you know. But I'm going to keep her and then sail her back to port and either repair her up or sell her on. So there you go, that ship is now got following me. It's got my flag design on it. So I'm going to go in here and I think we'll call that the end for this first episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Please join me again for more adventuring and pirating in the Caribbean. Until then, take care of yourself and goodbye for now.